creepy creature. They call the gazette, who balances things on his head, because it's flat. Or a stripe-loving pipester from Upper Mount Bet. Or a sort of a kind of a hat-wearing cat.
I can see you've got quite a mind for your age. Why, just one thing, and you've dragged me right onto the stage. Well, now I'm here and there's no telling what may ensue. With a cat such as me and a thinker like you. All the things you can think, all the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or a gink with a snake, or a stare to the sky. You open your mind, all the things you will find, lining up to get loose. All the things you can think, when you think about Seuss.
Of the day in the cool. of the pool. He was splashing, enjoying the jungle's great joys when Horton the elephant.
Horton the elephant!
Horton the elephant!
Heard a small noise.
He looked toward the sound.
That's funny,
thought Horton.
There's no one around.
Then he heard it again, just a very faint yelp,
as if some tiny person were calling for help.
Help! Help!
I'll help you,
said Horton.
But who are you and where?
He looked and he looked. He could see nothing there
but a small speck of dust blowing past through the air. I say, how confusing. I never heard tell of a small speck of dust that was able to yell. So you know what I think? I think there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Some poor little person who's shaking with fear and will go into the pool. He has nowhere to steer. He's alone in the universe. I'll just have to save them, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
He's always been friendly and
just had to save them, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small.
A person's a person, no matter how
small.
Troubles on you are the biggest that you've ever seen. not the end of our troubles here.
For on the other side of town, the Truffula trees were all cut down. They once stood tall in all their glory. But that's another story.
You're not making this my moment.
Here on
it might go along down where no one can see, right under state highway. firmness and terrible sorrow. Young man, we will deal with you come tomorrow.
It's possible.
Anything's possible.
Maybe so.
Oh, where are the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has all the answers? I don't know.
Does he drive teachers wild with his uncontrolled thinking?
As a parent, are you overwhelmed? Insecure? The help that you seek is inside this brochure!
It's night and sun, rise and shine sun. It's a very special day.
Get dressed, here, look your best, dear. Soon you will be on your way.
Now here's your pencil. Here's your sword.
My sword?
Makes the ball.
over a week. Getting laughed at for thinking that a dust speck can speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind. For I have found something that they'll never find. There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air. Hidden planets, tiny worlds, all invisible. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There is no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain, at one time or other, great thinkers all feel this way.
Salute.
scene's over. There's more to be heard. There goes our hero. Now who enters?
The bird!
Love song for Warden, 493. Doo 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 doo. There once was a girl bird named Gertrude McFuzz, and she had the smallest plane.
Sorry.
because here's where things go wrong.
Thank you. when you're limping along, getting kicked from me. Oh, tell yourself how lucky you are. Why did cry a cloudy sky and empty birds, crazy universe? My philosophy is simply things could get worse.
What?
So we have you here, think of life as a thrill, and if worse comes to worse, as we all know it will, thank your lucky stars, you've got this far. We're here in this beautiful theater, and you're in the first row. How lucky to be in the theater, more lucky than you know. You could have the luck of the heroes whose luck's been running low, for certain.
Inside, a great patch of clover is 100 miles wide. I'll find it. I'll find your bust. I shall find my friends in their small speck of dust. Clover by clover by clover with care. I'll listen and I'll call.
Are you there? Are you there?
You, not to mention all my stamina to follow you across the hills and deserts. But I feel as though I'm ready to confess to you the feelings that I've hidden with great diligence and labor behind the facade of your odd little next door neighbor. My eyes are too small, I have very large feet, and I'm not very proud of my pitiful. But I've now got a tail that is something to see.
102, 103.
Oh, notice me, Horton, feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me, Horton, Horton together. We could be great. Oh, notice me, Horton, put down.
999,999. It's hopeless!
You said it, kid.
Who's there?
Oh, it's me, Maisie. Up here!
Maisie? Are you on a nest?
Yeah, you wanna make something of it?
Oh no, I just never thought I'd see you on a nest.
Neither did I, Hort. Neither did I. I won't be gone long, kid. I give you my word. I'll hurry right back because I'm that sort of bird. Oh, Horton, I promise. I'll fly back real soon. I'll only be gone for, say, one afternoon.
Well, we all need vacations. All right, go on and take it. I'll sit on your egg and I'll try not to break it. But please come back quickly, an hour, maybe two. I've got to find JoJo and I've got to save who.
Hit it, cat!
your life's going wrong and you're wondering why.
When your tail is so long you're unable to fly, tell yourself how lucky you are. When you met with a thud and you're bumped and you're bruised,
when you're trapped,
you're frowning and you're lost and confused, tell yourself how lucky you are.
We've got to sweep up the stage and get ready to play act two.
So tell yourself how lucky you are. How lucky you are. How lucky you are. How lucky, how lucky, how lucky you are.
Poison!
So our story resumes. consumes on a terrible day as Horton gets carried away.
Up out of the jungle, up into the sky, up over the mountains, 10,000 feet high,
and down from the mountains and down to the sea. Went over to the elephant, I guess the tree.
They loaded the wagon right onto a ship.
Pardon me. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Seussical. Our first item of the piece this evening is Lot 39, a pendulous pachyderm on egg, nest, and tree. Let the bidding begin at 10,000. I hear 10,000, 10,000, 10,000, 11,000, and a saxophone. Can we get 12,000, 12,000, saxophone, 12,000? There's a woman back there on the fifth row holding up a baby. 15,000 and a baby, 15, there's somebody all the way in the back holding up a small adult, 18,000 and a small adult, 18, 20,000, 20, sold! To the man with the greasy black sideburns. Oh, I'm sorry, madam, sold to the man from the circus.
The circus, my goodness.
are. There's a crick in your tail and a crab in your toes. Your arms, who knows what trail, and your who is who knows. Tell yourself how lucky you are. I'm worried for JoJo and all of the rest. They're lost in the clover, I'm stuck on a nest. I'll sit up and say, cause what else can I do? Oh, Maisie, please find me, vacation is through. Maisie, please find me, I've got to save.
I meant what I said.
dude I said when I met. An elephant's faithful, 100%.
And now, little lady, you're alone in the universe too. Who would have thought you'd be left up to me? A fool of an elephant, up in a tree.
Well, this time I swear, I'll do better than try. I'll protect you from harm, I'll do it or die. So rest now, young egg, and I'll sing you a lullaby.
There's a faraway land, so the stories all tell. Somewhere beyond the horizon, if we can find it, then all will be well. Troubles there are few. Someday we'll go to Salazalu. Salazalu. Salazalu.
I've lost my poor hooves, and we've traveled so far. Oh, Jojo, forgive me, wherever you are.
Dear Mom and Dad, I'm thinking of you, and wishing we all were in Salazalu.
They say breezes are warm there.
Are kind.
Maybe it's something like heaven. I close my eyes and I see in my mind skies of bluest blue. Salazalu.
I've had so much trouble finding way there. When I get close, it dissolves. If we can get there, we'll stay there.
If it takes us miles,
if it takes us
miles, if it takes us years, high on a mountain or lost on the sea,
sooner or later I'll find it.
I have a picture of how it will be on the day I do.
Troubles will be new,
and I'll be home with you.
Salazalu.
Salazalu. arrived at the war like we said that we would. And war's a thing that does every boy good. We will sleep in the trenches and go without supper to make the world safe from every butterside upper. And we will shoot all traitors and every out-of-towner who side with those bibulous butterside downers. Any questions?
Sir, this war makes no sense. Just one thinking you'd quit. Spreading bread, up or down, doesn't matter a bit. We're lost in the clover. There's no help in sight. So why are you here teaching children to fight? And not only that, sir, it's Christmas on who? I'd rather have Christmas than war, wouldn't you?
No.
So here's my sword, and here's my hat. I'm going home, and that, sir, is that.
It's a minefield out there. There's no time to play.
I think what I think. Now get out of my way.
Soldier, you will obey. You will halt. Jojo, come back. Son, wait.
And the Grinch with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow stood puzzling and puzzling, oh, how could it be so?
It came without ribbons!
It came without tags!
It came without packages, boxes, or bags!
Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from the store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then?
Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart grew three sizes that day!
And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. He
Why, thank you, Mr. Grinch. As always, a wonderful Christmas show. And may I say, we're most grateful this year, for we've had much trouble, I fear. We've crashed in a clover, things smashed and things tore. Our town is a mess and our planet's at war. But that didn't stop Christmas from coming, it came! Somehow or other, it came just the same. So let's make a toast that war won't arrive here, that Horton will find us and we'll all stay alive here.
And here's to our JoJo! Our sweet, precious son, who's still off at war, but I'm sure having fun.
In the Battle of Butter, your son has been lost.
Lost?
When the butter began, the young man paid the cost.
Oh no.
He did not want to fight, and he may have been right. Here's his sword, and here's his hat. Regrets, and good night. Turn hard!
how sad, how unspeakably dreary, the parents despairing, and oh, terribly teary, and poor little Jojo no longer alive.
But wait, could it be that the kid did survive? A reenactment! Let's see, we need some actors. Okay, you stand there, you stand here. Son, it's a minefield out there. This is no time for play.
Sir, I think what I think. Now get out of my way.
Son, you will halt. You will obey. Run down the aisle, go. No, son, wait. Boom, explosion.
Sudden hunch you should follow your toes. Soon a sneaky hunch is whispering, better go straight. And before you know it, oh, it's so late, 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 late. Now a nervous hunch is telling you you could be lost. As it leads you down a path you have already crossed. And bunch. Now you know you're having a hunch. A hunch.
Your hunches, praise your wonder.
does. But Gertrude did something that few birds could do, so this is the tale of Miss Gertrude, part two. Horton! Horton! Horton!
Who's there?
It's me, Gertrude. I was so worried. Are you all right?
Gertrude, how'd you find us?
Well, it's a long story. I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little. It was absolutely giant, and it really was attractive, but you never even noticed, so I felt a little silly even trying. Besides which, the tail was too heavy for normal flying.
Go on.
Well, when the hunters caught you, I could see that I'd been foolish because I couldn't even help you. I couldn't even fly. And I got so very frightened because I knew I had to save you. No one else was going to go through all that labor. It was all up to me. All you had was your next door neighbor. So I ran to the doctor.
The doctor named Dick, and she said,
my tail has been a mistake.
And she said,
Dr. Dick, I've been foolish and vain. Pluck it out. Get it off. I won't do it again.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ooh, a tender spot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Just a one feather tail.
But suddenly,
no matter how.
Ha! Ha! Ha!
Well, Lord, we're taking you back. You're gonna be going inside. We're talking to his back and sitting on it.
Don't give up, I believe.
small, and you small persons will not have to die if you make yourselves heard. So please try.
Now just for a moment, young Jojo looked grim. The fate of the Who's rested squarely on him. But then came a thing, a peculiar new word. The kind of a word no one ever had heard.
Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I mean? They made themselves heard. Though they still can't be seen.
They prove they are persons, no matter how small.
And their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
How true, yes, how true, said the sour kangaroo. And from now on, do you know what I'm planning to do? From now on, I'll protect them with you. And the young kangaroo in her pouch said, me.
Their troubles were ended. They hailed his great
yeah!
And Jojo was honored as thinker non-stop.
Now all Jojo's things would forever be heard.
Including this thing. An elephant bird!
Why, he looks just like me, except for the wings.
And except for the voice, because that's how a bird sings.
Oh, Gertrude, what will I do?
I'm slow, I'm fat, all I know is the earth. I don't need much more than that.
I have wings, yes, I can fly.
Just call my name, and I'll see you through. One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Who believes in you?
Their adventures were over. The sky became pink! And then guess what happened? Well, what do you think?
Together.
Okay, first off, thank you to all of you for coming out to support this production. I know a lot of you came both tonight, and we appreciate you so much for being here, so thank you. I really would like to thank all of the staff involved, but I know the students are going to go into more detail with that in a little bit. And so I would like to announce all of our student crews in a little bit and invite them to come to the stage, because this entire production is run by the students. I just sit right there and do nothing for these productions. So they literally are doing everything behind the scenes. So I'll call each crew up as we go. First off, we have to definitely acknowledge this incredible pit right here. Along with a few faculty members that gave up their time. Okay, I'd like to call down hair and makeup to join us on the stage. And our heads of hair and makeup are Gina Camisa and Melissa Visco. Makeup and hair stuff that was involved in this production, and it took hours, so they really worked hard on this, so we thank you. I'd like to invite a costume crew to join us right now. And they set everything up for the students before they came into the room, and they were so organized and amazing and just took care of so many details that made it so great. The next crew that I'd like to invite is props. And it is headed by Miguel Valencia right there. Almost 100 props, and he was in charge of keeping everything organized and making sure the actors had to. I'd like to call the paint crew down next. Paint crew! And it is headed by Kathy Goodhart. Next, I'd like to call down sound. Come on down. By Pam Doles, who's right there. And where's Christina? Christina Bonadonna, right there. This production involved so many microphones. I think we used 20, right? 20 different mics. So they did all the mic checks, and then they were watching the script and making sure everybody's mics were on when they needed to be on. So a very important job. Thank you so much. Next, I'd like to call down the lighting crew. And lighting crew was headed by, I'm trying to see if they're here, Christian Marone, who's right over here. And the Lorax, Rob Ryan. With me, we came up with the whole lighting design for everything. We were up in the booth calling every shot, and we were having spotlight problems yesterday, and they figured everything out and made it happen for tonight, so we appreciate that. Did I forget any clues? I don't think I did. However, there are some, well, the running crew, which is also construction crew as well, so come forward if you are on the running crew or construction crew. That did did an incredible job backstage. I trust them with everything. They are incredible. So Panawa right here. I'd like to invite our amazing assistant stage manager to the stage, Caitlin. She was with us at literally every rehearsal and was calling all of the cues for Act Two and did an incredible job. This was her first year being part of stage management. She did not least, we have to thank the incredible stage manager that we have, Matt Montalione. He also was at every rehearsal with me, helped me figure out everything, was my right-hand man, and just did everything that I needed, and I couldn't be more fortunate to have had you the last couple of years. We will miss you so much when you go away, and we thank you so much for doing an amazing job. So as you can see, this production involved close to 180 students. And so between all the crews and the cast, and they did such an amazing job. So can we give one more round of applause to everybody? And now I'm going to turn the mic over to the students.
Yeah.
Okay, so obviously, we're mostly students running everything, but there are staff and adults who supervise us and guide us and make all this possible. So, one of the people that we're thanking today is not here, but...
Well, we don't know his last name, but we call him Cool Eric because he's the coolest guy here. And, yeah, Sith Lord Eric. Not only did he teach us how to build this amazing set back here, but he taught us how to be great people and have fun while we're working.
We want to give flowers to Miss Capasso. She stepped up and helped us lead all the painting when we didn't have anyone, so thank you for doing that.
Miss Capasso was also in charge of paying props. Because last year we, at the end, yeah, sorry about that. Right, but last year we lost the bees who were pretty important to us. And Miss Capasso really, she really stepped it up. And we couldn't have done all this without her. So thank you, Miss Capasso.
Helps us so much. He's just like the coolest guy ever. Sorry, cool guy Eric, but Joe's cooler. So Joe Hassett, can you come get your phone?
Beautiful people worked so hard, and the leader of this group of people, we would like to give these flowers to. He's also the director of the vocal jazz, which is extremely talented. Come see us at the next concert. We would like to give these flowers to Mr. K.
Thank you.
thank you so much. Wait, I got another telephone call. Wait. Yeah, the show's finally over. It was awesome. Give him a round of applause.
Hi. Okay, so as you can tell in the show, there's a ton of music, and it's really hard, and this next person worked really hard accompanying us. She came a little bit before the pit came to work with us, and she's really funny, and she makes us laugh during those long technical rehearsals, and we had to stop for a while.
And in addition to being an amazing accompanist, she is absolutely the most amazing chorus teacher and friend. Whenever we need her, she's there. She's devoted, passionate, all the positive characteristics you can name. She's our go-to. So without further ado, our flowers go to Mrs. Zatorski.
Anyone else other than her. And this amazing person stepped up and he helped choreograph this entire show. He put in so much hard work! It was honestly so easy to be dance. Me and Vitaly had such an easy time being dance captain. The show was amazingly choreographed and it was so easy to work with him. Mr. Mishki, please come up and make some
make it run away.
Without this person, none of this would have been possible. My personal inspiration since the sixth grade. Thanks for everything. And although you might have been our biggest critiquer, you are always our biggest cheerleader.
I think that, you know, because it's cliche to say like, oh, well, there wouldn't be a show without this person. But I mean, there literally wouldn't be a show without this person. Like, it wouldn't happen. It'd be mush. There wouldn't be anything. And then also, not only that, but the fact that when she started this year, it was just her. It was before all these other people came and helped out. A lot of directors would have just turned tail and ran away and been like, nope, I'm not doing that. But she stuck around and she did it. And she's so supportive. She's so supportive. She's so caring. Sorry. And I was gonna say something else. I was gonna say something else. I'll tell her later. Miss Mishki, would you please come accept these flowers?
Thank you so much. And again, I just want to acknowledge all the staff that helped put this together. There really was no one. They're not exaggerating it. Everybody came in and really helped step up to the plate. So again, I want to thank Mrs. Capasso, Cool Eric, because I really don't know how to pronounce his last name. Mr. K, Mrs. Zatorski, Joe Hassett, and especially my brother, Eric Mishki, for coming in to the And last but not least, I would just like to, because for a lot of these students, this is their last production in high school, and so I'd like to ask all the seniors to come onto the runway right here and take your final senior bow.
much for coming out to support this production. It means everything to us. We hope you have a great rest of the night and happy holidays.